Today we will show you how to summarize data in MS Excel through the mapping technique. Here is a large data of sales from January 1, 2018 to December 31, 2018, of various grocery items. Then we have the list of the same grocery items, categorized into different groups. This is the table that we want to create from this data. To do this, we need to map the grocery items to their respective categories. To map the grocery items to their respective categories, we will place the names of categories in front of each grocery item. We will just copy and paste the names of categories in front of the grocery items. Once you are done with the list, go to the sales sheet, and create a column named category. Using the VLOOKUP formula, bring each category name in front of their relevant grocery item. Lookup value is the grocery item. Table array is the columns B and C of the list of items. Column index is 2, referring to column C. MS Excel, VLOOKUP formula looks for the item in first column and returns the value from corresponding column given in column index, which in this case is the column C, having column index 2. Finally, we need to tell the formula to perform approximate match or exact match. Drag the formula all the way to the end of the table. We also need month names to summarize data by month. We need the month names in exact format as given in this table. In the sales table, create a column named month. Using the text formula, extract the month name from the date column. We will need a 3-character month name. Again, drag the formula all the way to the end of the table. Go to the summary sheet, and enter the SUMIFS formula to fill the table. Sum range is the sales column in sales sheet. Criteria range 1, is the category column in sales sheet. Make sure to fix the columns using the dollar sign. This will prevent Excel from updating the fixed columns when the formula is dragged. Criteria 1 is the category in summary sheet. Fix only the column name in Criteria 1, to stop Excel from updating the column when formula is dragged, but allow it to update the row. Criteria range 2 is the months column in sales sheet. Fix this as well. The criteria for this is the months row in summary sheet. Fix the row only to stop Excel from updating the row if the formula is dragged, but allow it to update the column. Now drag the formula from January to December, and from bakery to produce, leaving only the total row and the total column. The July column failed to update because the month names are 3-character, but July has 4 characters. Remove the Y from the end to resolve the issue. Now, calculate the totals for rows and columns, using the sum formula. This is it. You have just summarized a whole year-long sales data by categories and months. However, there is another way, even better way to summarize data more dynamically and efficiently. And that is through pivot tables, for which you don't even need the months column. Select the columns, go to the Insert tab, and insert a pivot table. Select the place you want to create the pivot table. Add date column to the columns area. Add category column to the rows area. And the sales column to the values area. Make necessary changes to the headings. You can even add further details to the categories by adding the items column as a child. You can hide the unnecessary information using filters in columns and rows. In case of blank cells, you can choose to display a value. You can format the values using the Format Cells window in the Value Field settings. As you can see, the pivot table is much better way of summarizing the information. It can be modified and altered at any time without any hard work. You can also expand and collapse the subcategories to show or hide the details. You can also instantly add charts using pivot tables. Just click anywhere on the pivot table, and select a chart from the Insert tab. Feel free to ask any question or leave a feedback in the comment section.